we go to the research center. Research, right? Augment. Augmentations. What am I making? A trap? Maybe it's development. Did say specifically research. Wait, I got this up here. Oh, it's just remnant tech. Cool. This stuff looks pretty cool. The Sweeper, a particle weapon that fires 3-shot bursts, is largely a mystery to its own developers. The weapon is derived from remnant technology, then repurposed for Andromeda Initiative needs. It does not require reloading, but it is prone to overheating. Sweeper should be turned over for study between missions. I don't like the overheating thing. It's an assault rifle. Particle accelerator weapon, PAW. Fires a continuous high-energy particle beam with incredible accuracy. For short-term operations, its power supply is effectively inexhaustible, and overheating is the only concern. The PAW combines remnant particle beam technology with Andromeda Initiative targeting and stabilizers. Theoretically, it may be scalable to a ship-sized version. Okay, so these are ones that you don't need ammo for. Like, I think it was the collector gun or whatever. You didn't need ammo, but it wasn't as hard-hitting. See all this stuff. A simple but powerful merger of remnant and initiative technology. The equalizer fires high-energy particle bursts that lose coherence and become ineffectual over distances. The short-range equalizer does not require reloading, but will overheat from continuous use. Initiative researchers are eager to see more field test data. See, the only question is, if it's going to be a pain in the butt overheating quickly, right? Scattershot shotgun. The scattershot fires particle blasts which can focus upon a target at range. This focusing effect is a result of advanced initiative targeting systems and invisible tracing of paths for the remnant-derived energy beams. The scattershot does not require reloading, but will overheat from continuous use. Cool. Shadow sniper rifle. Remnant particle technology is the cornerstone of the Shadow's design, though the Andromeda Initiative is responsible for the rest. This scoped rifle fires a continuous beam with pinpoint precision, only stopping if it overheats. As with all reverse-engineered remnant tech, the Shadow should be considered experimental. We got an Inferno sniper rifle. The Inferno began as a failed design for a remnant particle beam shotgun, then was reconfigured into a semi-automatic sniper weapon. It fires short, high-energy particle bursts and requires no reloading. This allows a sniper to continue firing until the weapon overheats. And finally, remnant cryo gauntlet. Look at that thing. The cryo gauntlet is an adaptation of a remnant hand tool. The user's Omni-tool forges the gauntlet around a remnant technology core and then snap-freezes an enemy with a flood of supercooled subatomic particles. Despite the dramatic visual, the surface freezing is painful, but not necessarily fatal. Okay, so we've got these two kind of assault rifles. We have to develop them all in order. Now, we go back and look at the PAW one. So I researched both. Damage 40. Accuracy 102. There's no real easy way to compare the two. 40, 60. So, infinity, max ammo. 40, 600. Don't care about the clip size that much. 102. 40, 600, 102. So I think I'm going to keep going with this. Damage is better. Rate of fire is smaller. Accuracy is almost the same. So I can develop this. Yeah, we have a lot of points. This is great. And five. Okay. So we've also got this Helios technology. Oh, we've actually got armor. Ooh, look at that armor. Remnant Heritage Arms. This armor was designed from scratch by the Initiative using Remnant technology. Its servos, microframe computer, and kinetic barrier regenerators are all dependent on Remnant science and artifacts. This resilient and regenerative hard suit has an energy surplus, though its internal systems can be difficult to properly monitor. Oh, really? I'll say the same. That's pretty cool looking. Look at that. We need at least 30 remnant polymers, and we have 900. Oh, we need more. We need a lot more silicon, or silicone, whatever. So we need to buy. I need to remember. I'm gonna write it down. Buy silicon and. Yeah, we need a lot of it. And hopefully this is worth it. It's like a good armor rating and all that stuff. I mean, I like the extras, you know, but forefront of my mind is keep me from dying. That's the most important thing. Beam emitter. This is a gun projectile augmentation. Alright. Weapon now fires a sustained energy beam that accurately deals rapid damage to the target. Sweet. Will override any fire type augment. Damage over time is the same as the base weapon. Weapon stability plus 200%. We've seen stuff similar. Okay, so now I need to apply it to my weapon. Or do I need to go into research for that? Or, yeah, because I'm in development. Now this stuff I think we looked at. I think. Maybe not. This stuff is interesting, so I'll just read about it. Hope you guys don't mind too much. So it's the Ishere Sniper Rifle. This heavy Angaran sniper rifle uses an entire thermal clip with each shot. Slow to reload, but it strikes with massive force. The Ishere's name translates as goodbye, and the weapon has few rivals when it comes to raw power. The Angara take understandable pride in its effectiveness. Ushior pistol. An Angaran pistol with an incredible punch, the Ushior, translated as resonance, fires slowly and needs constant reloading, but has massive stopping power. Its plasma energy discharge is likely derivative of Ket technology. Dan shotgun. The Dan is a Ket semi-automatic weapon which unleashes a single plasma-surrounded projectile that causes devastating damage. The Dan's large and dense projectiles can knock down opponents and generate magnetic fields sufficient to sustain plasma spheres. Dan appears to translate to Peacebringer. Yeah, peace because they're dead. The semi-automatic Hesh, translated to Order, is a Ket weapon that fires clusters of plasma-surrounded projectiles. Fired rounds are more powerful enough to stagger most foes and demand submission from the rest. Naladin Sniper Rifle. The Naladin, translated to Taker, is a scoped rifle capable of firing plasma-surrounded projectiles that explode on impact and burn anyone in the immediate vicinity. The Naladin mixes precision targeting with indiscriminate damage. What that says about Ket military culture is a subject best left to expert xenosociologists. Roserad submachine gun. A deadly Ket submachine gun with plasma-surrounded projectiles. The Roserad's firing rate increases with every shot. Interesting. Although clearly designed for Ket, the Roserad, translated to Infinite Fire, appears to incorporate technology from another species, perhaps an ally or Ket vassal. Sonad Assault Rifle. The massive Ket Sonad, translated as Resistance, rapidly unleashes plasma-surrounded projectiles after a brief charging period. Much of the Sonad's size is devoted to insulating the user from its own power. Yeah, we've read about this, actually. A damaged Sonad could incinerate its wielder's hands while continuing to fire. The Thoken, we know, we've seen that. I've picked that up. We are using the Zalkin, currently. Lanat Sniper Rifle. The Ket Lanat, translated to Watcher, is a slow-firing sniper rifle that uses plasma-surrounded projectiles. The user can charge the semi-automatic Lanat's magnetic field to modify the plasma containment. The longer the charge builds, the more powerful the shot. At full power, the Lanat is among the most deadly weapons in any galaxy. Cool. I don't use sniper rifles. Ket Karphalon Blade. The Ket Karphalon Blade can directly inject the user's hand with a variety of neurochemical stimulants. The Karphalon reinforces the body's reward mechanisms, allowing a combatant to overcome pain and fatigue after successful strikes. The weapon's ability to adapt to various species suggests the Ket occasionally give them to favored vassals. Angaran Furan. With few resources, the Angara are fighting a guerrilla war. Over many years, they have developed concealable, deadly, and nearly unbreakable weapons, including the Furan, an improvement on Milky Way monomolecular blade technology. This small knife can slice through well-armored foes and sharpens itself whenever resheathed. It's an improvement? I mean, yeah, but they didn't improve upon it. I mean, they obviously made that before we even came here, so... Saying it's an improvement specifically is kind of misleading. Ket Vakarsh. Translated as Punitive Immolation. Damn. Works on a similar principle as Ket firearms. A mechanical core, in this case a blade, sustains a magnetic field containing superheated plasma. The Vakarsh lacks the cutting power of a monomolecular weapon and ignites its victims instead. I have a little trouble saying that word. Monomolecular. And finally, Electric Furan. The Angaran Furan is a technologically advanced knife even without embellishment. But the deadly Furan can be augmented to channel an Angara's unique electromagnetic abilities into a powerful shock. This variation's power source uses initiative technology instead of biology, but delivers the same stunning jolt. Alright, interesting stuff. I'm going to research that. I'm going to save my points, actually, for this when we find, what is it? I wrote it down. Silicone. Research. We still have to do all this, actually. And we don't have enough for this, do we? Oh, just enough. Okay, so never mind, we're out of points anyway. Oh, can we still make that thing? I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing here. There are reports of an interesting and potentially lucrative activity in the Ramav system. While these reports alone seem vague, it is also the area that the Turian Ark may have been headed. Vetra and PB suggest that we check it out. Travel to H-047C in the Ramav system. In Eladen? Oh, we got a desert world? We already had a desert world. Jack is concerned about tensions at the Krogan colony on Eladen. He's forwarded you an email from Jorgal Strux, a well-respected Krogan from an old family. Strux has asked to meet you at a trading post called Paradise. He's also asked that you keep it a secret. Travel to Eladen in the Zarbray system to meet with the Krogan contact. Right. And you have obtained the spy's transponder and must use it to reveal the location of the Archon's flagship. So this is all priority stuff. Know your enemy. Speak with Sam in Sam node. I think we have to go back to the Hyperion for that. I guess in our quarters is not the node. Liam thinks it's time for something familiar, like a day out on Aya. He also mentioned getting your eyes on something, but he wasn't specific about what he meant. Talk to Liam at the Tevatan on Aya, yes, eventually. While gaining Ephra's trust, you have garnered the attention of the Rokar, a cell of Angaran fighters who hate all aliens. Jarl has information about the Rokar's leader, Axul. Turian encampment. What is this thing about? Crafting yet. Kadara. Reyes Vidal has sent an email asking you to contact him via comms. Read your email. Check your email and respond to Reyes. Yeah, of course. Now that we've left in the ship. Tempest, okay. The Visitor. Evidence suggests the creature's been eating the Tempest food stores. Build a trap to catch it. Build a trap at a research center. How? Let me build a trap. There's no category for trap. This is a research center. Craft new items. Oh, here it is. Humane trap. Special item blueprint. A humane trap designed to capture a small creature alive for future study. Cool, I wonder if there's going to be another miniature giant space hamster thing. We have more than enough aluminum, that's for sure. Yes, I am sure. Ta-da! Back to... Yeah, I don't have that stuff added in. But the gun, though. Pull out a sight rifle for... augmentations. What is this thing that we got? This, I guess it's not here yet. I could put some other stuff on it. Look at that. So we don't have enough whatever for that. Silicone. Agility mode. We have literally a lot of stuff here. So this I do want to get, more silicone. Advanced detection systems allows the occupants of the Nomad to detect enemies through obstacles at a range of up to 75 meters. I guess we see the little dot quicker. The upgrade will be installed automatically. New statistic. Advanced life support. Installs power cells that can briefly generate a mass effect field around the Nomad to shield occupants as they're exiting the vehicle. Okay, that's interesting. Agility mode. Allows the Nomad's stability assist, which is always on by default, to be disabled, giving an expert driver greater control over the vehicle. With stability assist disabled, the Nomad is more agile, but will have less traction when cornering. Press num plus to switch between modes. Huh. Interesting. Defensive fortification. Improves the Nomad's shield strength and frame integrity by 25%. Going for this so far? I guess we put this one on already? Because it's grayed out. Oh, it's grayed out because we don't have the silicone. Emergency shield discharge. When the Nomad shields are entirely depleted, shield cells will discharge, generating a shockwave that sends nearby enemies flying. Sweet. Improved boost. Oh, nice. I want this. Expands booster chambers to provide a longer boost in both drive modes. Cool. Okay. Improved suspension. Increase the Nomad's top speed in four-wheel drive mode. Go for it. Supercharged boost. Ooh. We need more graphite for this. Greatly improved airflow and fuel injection allows for an even longer boost time. Goals. Supplemental life support. Allows the Nomad's life support system to improve functioning in extreme environments. Tempted. I think I'll go for that next. This we don't have enough platinum for. Torque management. Six-wheel drive. Improves torque in six-wheel drive, allowing for faster top speed in that mode. And vertical thrust upgrade. Increases the force generated by vertical thrusters by 40%. Again, need more platinum. So let me make a little note about platinum. I need to buy a lot of silicone, but we only need 60 or so platinum. Go for the life support. So it's in my inventory, so then the upgrade will be installed automatically. Okay. Oh, we still have to do this. Didn't we do it already? I think I just made two of them or something. Alright. Initiative spear point arms. Let me look at this. Standard issue, Andromeda Initiative hard suits are designed for exploration as much as combat. Combining jump jets, high-grade external and internal sensors, and a variety of atmospheric filters with the usual kinetic barrier generators and ceramic armor plating. This particular suit has been customized according to specific hazard data gathered from the Helios cluster. So we got plus 7% max shields, plus 4% encounter XP increase, and plus 10% max shields with the chest. More max shield, 7% with the helmet. Plus 7% encounter XP increase. Yeah, I'm not going to look at any of this other stuff. What I want to do is... Yeah, so I was in... What was I in? I was in research. This is development. So I went and do these augmentations. What did I find? I was in research? Wait. It's in research. Yeah. It's this augmentation. Beam emitter. That's what I want to apply. No, I want to be in development, right? This is just a little confusing the way it's set up. Wait, paw 4, that's what I wanted. So the augmentation... Oh, we need that. Is that why we can't add an augmentation? We need graphite. So, do we have access to the other, the three? No, we still need graphite. I probably messed that up somehow. I wanted to add the beam emitter to it. Alright, well, I made a trap. Place a trap at the creature's lair, which is where? Here. Back where the crumbs were? Is that one? In the bridge? I guess so. By PB's room?
So, Callow, who's that woman I keep seeing you with on the Nexus? What? Whom?
You're always short of credits after we come back. Is it
downstairs?
It's complicated, Suvi.
It always is. Yeah, I guess back where we saw the crumbs. Yeah, that's where its nest is. Makes sense. Activate.
One trap ready for a visitor. I'll leave it and see what we get.
Cool. Wait for the trap to spring. Cool. Now what? Now what do I have to do? Just to the bridge, I guess. Yeah, to the bridge and emails. And using a ladder correctly. Get that workout. Okay. Kello!
I hear you found a stasis locker from the Solarian Ark.
Technically, someone else found it first, but yes.
How wonderful! I know it's not the Ark itself, but any sign is better than nothing, surely. Please, yeah. If I can help the search at all, just ask.
Don't call
or
me Shirley.
Ask anyway. You're good company.
Nah. Your opinion on the others? It's white here.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
No. If I gossip any more, I'll get in trouble.
Tell me something else about the ship.
O'Connell, our systems designer, was running a power distribution model. How power moves through the ship. But he forgot to lock his terminal and we... For two days, poor O'Connell was convinced that turning on all the bath...
Yep, heard that one. Thanks. anything going on in her? Always checking her quarters. See, that's her little research thing. Yeah. And how's my favorite science officer?
Pathfinder.
Oh, nothing to talk about.
I should get back to things. Sounds good.
Disappointing. Nothing to talk about at all. Email, I'm sure I've got tons. Yes, call me. To Ryder from Reyes Vidal. Ryder, thanks again for your help with Zia and the Rokar. I owe you something special, and I think I found just the thing. Give me a call when you have a minute. Reyes. How do I give him a call? Aya diplomatic efforts. To Ryder from Director Jaren Tan. When we left our old home, we never planned on having to negotiate with an alien civilization for a new one. It's vital we placate the Angara and keep them on our side. They've opened an embassy on Aya, and our diplomatic team is already settling in. I'm counting on you to ensure our success. We have established ties with the resistance leader, the Moshai, and Aya's governor. Do all you can to learn everything about them and their supporters. The better we understand Aya's political structure, the more successful we'll be gaining their help colonizing Helios. Director Tan. In your debt to Ryder from Sellers. I wanted to send my appreciation for clearing my dear friend Sanjeev's name. I hate to imagine the ordeal he was subjected to by the exiles who took him, but it does my heart good to know that he will be remembered as a faithful member of this incredible endeavor and not a traitor. I barely remember these Sellers and Sanjeev. Perhaps now I can finally put the Nexus revolts behind me and start looking to the future. Yours, Sellers. Error 982. Carrier signal interrupted. Invitation. From unknown sender. Ryder, I must be brief, but I hear my virus was a success, and Sam is disconnected. Excellent news. What? We should talk in person. I've enclosed the nav point for our sanctuary on Kadara. The virus was only a first step. You could be a strong ally in future efforts. Knight. Sam is not disconnected? I don't know what you're talking about. But yeah, this has to do with that quest. We have to go back to the Nexus. Something about someone against VI. Please see me. From Captain Dunn. Ryder, please see me on the Hyperion deck to discuss a sensitive matter. Dunn. I wonder what it has to do with our brother. Something suspicious. From Sidera Nix. Dear Pathfinder, this is Sidera, Vetra's sister, but everyone calls me Sid. I know this isn't following protocol because who am I to conduct a Pathfinder through their personal console, right? But I know Vetra will tell me I am overreacting, and I swear I wouldn't do this unless I thought it was something serious. There's just stuff going on here that doesn't really add up, and people are getting hurt. It's hard to explain. Can we talk in person? I'm in operations. Thanks. Sid Aranix. Oh my god, there's so many. You're making waves. From Reyes Vidal. Spread the word at Tartarus and in port of your expert handling of the Rokar. I only made a few embellishments and left out my involvement, of course. Wouldn't want to steal your spotlight. Not that I really could. You're something else, Ryder. Reyes. War, thanks, shucks. About Zia. From Reyes. In case you're wondering, my taste in women has improved since I ended things with her. Reyes. Fascinating. Thanks for listening. From Liam. Nuff said. Costa. Short but sweet. About Kadara. From Vetra. Hey, Ryder. One of my friends from Kadara sent a list of tips for surviving there. It's mostly common sense, but there are some gems. Well, that's nice, because we're done there. Or almost. And we gotta see Reyes again, apparently. No one knows who the charlatan is. Asking's dangerous. Yeah, well, we gotta find out. Be really careful dealing with Sloane and anyone who works for her. Politics on Kadara are less about who's got the biggest stick and more about who's willing to use the sticks they have in creative ways. There's a hole-in-the-wall place in the slums that makes the best cup of Kiloa. In all caps, do not mix Kiloa with other stimulants, no matter what anyone says, humans only. Yeah, some of this stuff is, like, a little too late. Don't ask Umi the bartender to surprise you, Vetra. Did I ask her? I'm not even sure. Invitation, diplomatic meeting, from the Nexus Cultural Exchange. Oh, I remember that. To Pathfinder Ryder, we are currently hosting the first Angaran ambassador to the Nexus, Issa D. Navarre. Despite the importance of your duties, we hope your next return to the station will coincide with his visit. Sure it will. A cordial meeting between the Pathfinder to first reach Aya and the Angaran ambassador could set the tone for our relations in the future. Respectfully yours, Lorna Tesafra, Chief of Staff, Nexus Cultural Exchange. Matriarch credits from Drac. Last time I was on Kadara, I met this Asari at Corella's, who said she'd let me in on a little score. Well, you were just there, so it couldn't be that long ago. Apparently there's this matriarch who came over on a Nexus, only she died in stasis. My contact says she's next in line for the old lady's credits. A lot of credits. And get this, she says she'll split them with me. Trouble is, there's red tape. Transfer fees. And she's having trouble mustering up the credits to clear 'em. Ask me if I could cover the transfer cost. I tried to bring Vetra in on this, but she says it's a scam. I'm not so sure. Seems like a pretty good opportunity to me. Drac. Matriarch credits. From Drac. It was a scam. Do me a favor and don't tell Vetra, okay? Non-work-related email from Jal. Ryder. I told Liam and PB and Lexi a children's story that the mothers used to tell us when we were small. It's from our oral history of the time before the Scourge. The crew said I should write it down so that it can be added to the cultural center on the Nexus. The Wayward Child. Long ago, there was a child who was very stubborn and wouldn't listen to any wisdom, not from her father, nor from her mothers. One day, seeking adventure, she snuck aboard a spaceship with an unknown destination. That child was brave to seek adventure. However, she ended up getting space with a load of garbage. Deservedly, she froze in the cold vacuum of space and died. The end. What? I don't know why the crew enjoyed it. It's a terrible story meant to scare youngsters into obedience. Is this a novelty to your people? If so, how do you humans keep children from hurting themselves? Jal. I'm not sure. Do they view it as a horror story or something? I'm not sure. Two more. This sounds bad, kid. Oh, this is part of the 1.08 thing. You can reconstruct your face. Yeah. To Ryder from Drac. Thought I'd show you what Strux sent me. A transcript of an audio log that's got me worried about the colony. Sounds like Morta's cooking up something. Don't know what to think. Morta. Stop arguing with me, Brink. It's payback time for the initiative. Brink says, they don't care about us. Morta says, but they will. Soon they're going to know that I'm Overlord. And once I execute my plan, there'll be no denying that the Krogan rule Helios. Then they'll come begging to us. Okay, Morta. I'll get a team together. Gather everything we need. No Krogan bows down to the Nexus again, Morta says. Facial reconstruction. From Lexi. Ryder, I've completed my analysis of the injuries you suffered on Habitat 7 during the fall, well, both falls, including the facial damage incurred when your helmet shattered. Those hairline subsurface fractures are mending nicely. If you want to monitor the healing process, there's a facial reconstruction site installed in the Tempest Med Bay. Exploring harsh environments can take its toll, after all. The suite can make any desired adjustments and keep your appearance quickly... Can make any desired adjustments to your appearance quickly and safely. Kalo claims the suite runs on antiquated xenon. I think that's one of his little jokes. Lexi. I guess so. Call Reyes. Oh, I guess on the conference room table thing. Wait for the trap. Where's the call thing? Right here. Call Reyes Fidal at Kadara Port. Activate.
Ryder.
Reyes.
I was just thinking about you.
Sorry, we have an audience. This doesn't sound urgent.
Suvi said you called about something important.
Thought you could use a night off. Sloan's holding a get-together for the locals. I managed to snag an invite. Care to be my plus one?
Sloan's hosting a party?
Sloan doesn't seem like the party type.
She sees these events as a necessary evil to keep the people happy.
Is this a date?
Are you asking me out?
I promise to be a perfect gentleman.
You better.
This is just a friendly night out.
Whatever you want, Ryder.
Sounds fun, though.
I'd never say no to free drinks.
Especially from Sloan's Reserve. I'll meet you outside Outcast HQ.
Okay. We got a crap load of stuff to do. Holy crap. We are going to be passing 200 videos for sure. Oh, PB's over here now. Anything new to say? Now that you're over here?
Hi there. Just checking in. What's up?
Okay. Gonna do this. If she starts getting cringy again, I'm gonna space past it.
I like it when you...
Yep.
Have I flirted with you? Don't worry, Ryder. I'm relentless. It relaxes me. Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later. You know it.
Alright, so... did these guys finish their thing in the meantime? Because it's been a while. In progress. Alright. So, okay. I do wanna... Yeah. Not sure. Next episode might be some more codex reading. And then we're going back. Pretty sure it's going to go in this order. We're going to go back down to Kadara, since we're still here. Then we're going to the Nexus and do all the Nexus and Hyperion stuff. And then we're going to Eos and either finish or do as much as we can on Eos. And then I think we're going to Havarl, because it's been forever since we were given the quests for Havarl. And then we'll see where we're going to go with other systems, these new areas that have been given to us. So we have a lot of crap to do. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one, and endure. In enduring, grow strong. Thank you.